This is my 1.6 HDI Peugeot Partner 2007 92 brake horsepower non-DPF engine, and this is a video dissecting a fuel filter, 1.6 HDI fuel filter. What are the different lines? What are the different openings? What are the different things? What are these pipes? What is this valve here? I'll cut it open to see it inside. How often do you need to replace it? How often do I replace it? If you want to see that, stay tuned. And what does the fuel filter do? Well, it filters fuel. In that case, it filters diesel fuel. So from your main tank, a line comes in here and goes through the filter and comes out of here and goes to your injectors. What I'm missing here is a diesel heat element that is that small, has a protruding here, something like this, that you stick inside, click it inside, and that's a heater element. I don't really have it because it's already in my fuel filter. That's the replacement that I just replaced my fuel filter. What does this do? In order to prevent gelling of the diesel fuel, it heats up slightly the diesel that comes from the fuel tank and goes inside. So you don't really want, if the temperature is too low, you don't want the fuel to gel. It goes inside, it comes out of here. So this heat element slots in here, in that hole underneath there. It slots in underneath here, so these two have to hold the diesel element, and it comes inside here. It has two rubber O-rings to stop diesel coming out. Put a piece of paper there because this filter has still a bit of diesel inside. Next thing, that hole that I'll shine my torch so you can kind of see it. You can see there is a thread there, so something screws in there, and there is a plastic at the end, so nothing leaks out. And there is a small kind of dirt plastic down here. So this hole is for water in diesel sensor, something like this. That's the water in diesel sensor. It has a rubber O-ring here. This thread screws on the fuel filter down here. It has two metal prongs. Hopefully you can see it has two metal prongs and a plastic that sticks out a bit. So it measures resistance, so it knows when there is water inside the filter element. And how does it know that there is water inside the filter element? So in this glass cup, I've got diesel fuel that I've poured in there. And in my other hand, I've got water, the tap water. So if you pour it in, let's pour it like that. So what you can see, after a while, I can't tip it very well, that the water comes at the bottom and the diesel fuel comes on top. Something like this. I position the camera a little bit better. The water is at the bottom, the diesel fuel is in the top, and they perfectly separate. There is a bit of a layer here that some molecules. After about 5 minutes, it's a perfect separation between the water in the bottom and the diesel at the top. So the water in diesel sensor screws down at the bottom, and because the filter is situated in the engine like that, with the bottom down, the same thing if you have a condensation in your fuel tank, you have some water, or somehow water has entered in the fuel tank, the water will go to the bottom, the diesel fuel will go to the top, and this with resistance, it will measure the resistance. There is a different resistance from the water and from the diesel. So you screw it up until you hear a crack, and this gets entered, and these two prongy bits have a contact with the air filter. I think this is roughly about 3 Newton meters, so it's very light. You don't need to turn it too strong, otherwise you'll damage the threads of the plastic. So you can see these are fairly similar. The plug here that has 3 pins, that's for the electricity for the diesel and water sensor. But this, most cars do not come with water and diesel sensor, and they just come like that. So the plug that goes into the water and diesel sensor, you just plug it in there, and that's plastic in the end. You just plug it in there so the cable doesn't dangle. That's why this hole in there and that hole in there. Let's imagine your computer, you have a water and diesel sensor, and your car tells you there is water in the diesel, whatever the reason. So what can you do about this water in diesel? So the next pipe, there is a small outlet coming out of here. So this is related to that valve at the top. So what this valve does, you open, if you know, because the water is at the bottom, the diesel is at the top. Basically, if you undo that valve, the water that is the bottom of the filter will leak out. And then you close it and you've purged out the water from your water in diesel sensor. Normally, on my car has disappeared, there is a pipe that comes out of here connected to that little outlet and goes down at the bottom of the engine, not to leak in the middle of the engine. So let's see what will happen if I undo that valve and pour it in and put it like that. You need to be a bit of on the strong side. It's a bit tight, this screw and this valve. So if you undo it, and there you go, it starts leaking the water that I've poured in the filter. And what's in here, I mean, you have that small bit that has an O-ring here and an O-ring at the bottom. Basically, that stops seals here and seals down there. So you screw it back in again. You've purged the water in the diesel filter. Close it back again. And that's it. It doesn't leak anymore. And if you remove the water in the diesel, Next thing, what about these interesting cuts here and there? And there is a plastic that you can pull out here. Well, this is for the bracket that you put it in. It slides underneath here and clicks on that protruding bit. So then you take it out, you press on this and pull it out. And that's it. That's what you can see looking at the fuel filter. So next is to cut the fuel filter, cut it lengthwise like that and open it to see what's inside. So this was the fuel filter, and I've cut it here along everywhere. And what's inside, that's the back cover. And the front, not really much. There is a paper element inside, some plastic underneath. If you peel this off, you can probably see, hopefully you can see it. There is this pipe that doesn't come to the bottom, comes out here and comes out there. So the fuel gets squirted from here, goes inside, gets filtered, and comes out of here. You probably can't quite see, and but down there, hopefully the ending, actually, let me point it out. In the middle down there, it's where the diesel fuel sensor connects there, so it's at the very bottom and picks up this water in diesel. I also cut the filter even a bit more, so from horizontally here, so you can see the other side as well. So that's the filter with the paper element and the pipe coming to the bottom. But here I wanted to show that piece here. So this is where this is the valve for purging the water. It comes down here, hopefully you can see it. So you unscrew it, has twisted a bit. It's quite tight as well, very difficult to unscrew. You twist it a bit, unscrew it. It stops here. There is a bit of a cut, so the water could go through. And that's how this operates. And it comes out of here. The additional thing I wanted to show here is the water in diesel sensor that screws on here. And it comes out of here. Currently there is just plastic, so if you don't have a sensor, this will block any fuel coming out. But if you have a sensor, you screw it here, you turn it until you hear a crack, and the crack is this plastic breaking. Basically, the water in diesel sensor has a plastic spot that is higher than these two pins, and this breaks the plastic. So let's quickly do that. There we go, it started already breaking. It cracked. Oh, it needs very little turning. So you can see this stays there. The plastic has broken. So basically this comes in contact with the diesel or the water and measures resistance and measure, and it will tell you if there is water in the diesel. Oh, it's basically water in the diesel sensor. And if you undo it, there is of course a hole through here. So next thing, how often do you need to replace your fuel filter? In the booklet of my car, for my Peugeot partner, the maintenance record and so on, you've got two operating conditions. One is normal operating conditions and one is arduous operating conditions. So under normal operating conditions, you replace the diesel fuel filter every 36 to 40,000 miles. And of course, under arduous conditions, you replace it between 20,000 and 24,000 miles. How do you define arduous conditions? Well, if you run your 1.6 HDI engine, lots of stops and goes, not one continuous journey, so the engine is not a lot in operating temperature, so then you're on arduous operating conditions. So if you run your car a lot of journeys that are continuous and the engine is operating, has achieved an operating temperature for longer periods of time, that would be considered normal operations. How often do I change it? Well, I change it every year. No matter what I do, I normally do about 12,000 miles a year, I change the diesel filter every year. I mean, this stops any small particles that are at the bottom of your fuel tank reaching your diesel injectors. That's why I always never really let my fuel tank get too empty and then drive on that, because it sucks all possible things and the condensation of water is down there as well. So I change it every year, or roughly about 10,000 miles. I've halved the arduous operating conditions. Well, yeah, I know it's a bit too much, but for the price of the fuel filter, which is quite cheap, it's actually worth doing. So this is all I wanted to say about diesel fuel filters. Let me know for any comments in the comment section. Thank you very much indeed for watching.